Thank you, Patricia, for outlining some very clear key priorities. So our third speaker is Olga Balieva. Olga is a membership and community strengthening manager at the Eurasian Harm Reduction Network. She's also a member of the Eurasian Network of People Who Use Drugs and an active member of the International Network of Women Who Use Drugs. So she will be speaking on key priority issues and needs from the Eastern Europe and Central Asia region. Thank you, Olga.
Good morning, dear friends and colleagues. I am thankful for the opportunity to talk to you about the situation with drug policy and harm reduction programs in Central and Eastern Europe and Central Asia. Yes. In my presentation, I would like to tell you how joint efforts we are changing the situation towards a humane drug policy and what are the main problems to be solved in the nearest future to save people's lives. This year's Eurasian Harm Reduction Network celebrates its 20th anniversary. Thank you. And I remember time from 1997 to 2003. That was the time when harm reduction was an improved product for our region, international, some of these members. Participant came to our region and were telling about the harm reduction philosophy and approaches. This was a time of underground syringe exchange clubs. NSP program were focused on the safety of the veins and culture of the drug use. We were talking about the cooking methods and with fairy eyes, full of surprise and admiration, we're talking each other's story about the harm reduction program in New York and Amsterdam. In 2003, the programs on HIV contraction appeared. Harm reduction teams met the innovative approaches with hope and started learning. By 2010, the storage facilities were filled up with syringes and condoms. The partnership relation with AIDS Center were built. OST program started working. People got access to OST treatment. At that moment, 26 of 29 countries covered by Eurasian Harm Reduction Network activities in the region are supporting harm reduction intervention within HIV response. But why is the HIV epidemic in Eastern Europe and Central Asia region still continuing to rise? Besides the economic, social, and cultural sub-regional factors, I would like to talk about two reasons, because these are the reasons we must and can influence. First, HIV prevention programs didn't change the attitude towards the people who use drugs into a more tolerant one. Second, repression and decriminalization of drug use and of possession for personal use are escalating. The one-stop shop approach became a breakthrough for the relations between the HIV, TB, and narcological center. A person comes for OST and may receive also ARV and TB treatment at the same time. But all other needs of people who use drugs, which are beyond the scope of the services, of these services, they often remain uncovered. Please show the video.
сегодня я лежу в больнице. Мне очень плохо, потому что я не могу получать метадон в больнице. По своему состоянию, так как только сегодня у меня были вызывающие роды, наконец-то плод вышел, у меня идет кровь, я еще не могу сама передвигаться, я не могу ездить в больницу за метадоном. Сейчас мне плохо, больно. Я спросила, даже кетанова нету.
These cases happened in our region because of drug control department requesting military security to transport OST medicine from hospital, from OST services to hospital. Also, people who have been sticking the OST plan for years, I mean 3, 5, 7 years, still don't get to take OST home. That's the dark side of the one-stop shop solution. Criminalization is when the sentence for the remains of the heroin on the foil could mean from 3 to 12 years of imprisonment. Of course, OST in prisons is a unique breakthrough in cooperation between prison departments and healthcare system. But there are some specific. First 3 days after detention determine the fate of the person. At that time, the person is being interrogated in the condition of abstinence. To avoid pain, humiliation, and physical assault, people confess crimes they didn't commit and receive 3, 5, 8 year sentence. After being held in temporary detention facility, they go to prison, which may happen more than a year after last receive the OST. These are 2 ways of treating people who use drugs. And in our countries, government choose the path of repression. Economic crisis, significant decrease of donors' funding, military conflict. Is this solution the service focused on the needs of people who use drugs are the first to be cut? Eurasian Harm Reduction Network and our partners, we do all we can to keep the harm reduction services working in our region. Assessing countries' readiness to transfer from donor support to national funding, advocating for the inclusion of the expenses on NSP and OST services into the local budget, working to ensure the community watchdog the quality of services. However, without ensuring the right for private life, and safety, we can go far in our budget advocacy work or in our work on improvement of the quality of services. Support be provided to people who use drugs, inspired them to protect their rights through the international courts, ombudsman, UN structure. Believe me, no drugs has caused so much harm as the torture of people who use drugs by police, denial of access to treatment, corruption, and government double standard. The right for a private life already include the right for personal use of drugs. We now try to reduce harm from the repressive drug policy and inadequate action of government officials. Our strength is in unity and mutual support. Each moment of working here with you give us force and courage to move forward towards the world where people respect each other, choose and understand the key value. Heads could be different, but human rights are universal. Thank you.